I am Dr. Sharon Chidebere Ohaka. I am from Isial and Banonimo State, and I am the State Coordinator, Partners for Peace Network. In 2004, November, I and in fact the Obiahon community witnessed the first political motivated crisis or conflict. It was a by-election of a replacement election or so. We had a late member of House of Representatives who just died and he was supposed to be replaced. So a patriotic or philanthropic son of the village, Obiahon, came home and actually wanted to contest for the position. Actually, the late House of Rest member was not from my village, he was from another place. And from normal political zonings in the states, that area and that local government was supposed to produce his replacement. But from the arrival of a son of the soil to contest that position, the village took to his side. For some of us who said no, we have to stand by the normal political arrangement, we became problem. And that escalated to a problem where there was a division. And at the end of the day, on the day to the election, there were so many plans to eliminate me and some other principal stakeholders. I used to be the youth president, the youth leader, but when I was called out as a youth leader, they rejected me because they felt I was not supporting the man who is from my village. On the day of election, because from the night I did not sleep in my village. On the day of election, I arrived at the village around 8 a.m. in the morning with a local government vehicle. So as I arrived, while I was climbing up a hill to the village square, the contestant was going down to the local government along the road, and he was on a bike. And following him was a bus, a 300 bus, with so many armed men. So when our vehicle passed him, he just said, "Look at them." That was what he said. And we branched off to somewhere. So the vehicle turned and came to us. So when they came down there, they met me behind a man's house, and I was talking with the man. So the first boy that was going, I just asked, "What did I do to you?" And before I could finish it, gunshots have started raining. So I just entered the bush. They shot all through that place. They now ran after the vehicle that brought me, scattered it, so the man went. So when they could not catch me and they could not catch the vehicle, they had to go to my house. Went to my house, destroyed the whole house. They carried my sick uncle from his sick bed and threw him on the floor. Destroyed the house, went to my uncle's house, destroyed things. In fact, they nearly burned, they beat up so many people. And in fact, when the police came, the whole village was deserted for about 2, 3, 4 days. Everybody was on the run. That kept us in backwardness, lack of peace, there was distrust, the youths we are used, a lot of them, in fact, there was chaos in the community for a period of 6 months until some people started coming to us who they saw as the principal victims to ask us to forgive the community for what, and after much, we had no option than to say, let there be peace.